Zimbabwe. His consultancy work on tourism development in and around national parks and heritage sites took him to Slovenia, Albania, and Bulgaria. Importantly, in 1998, he wrote the first paper on tourism and poverty elimination for the DFID, and this led on to work in terms of pro-poor tourism partnerships and into training, evaluation of consultancy work, and generally looking at localized economic development and poverty reduction. Since the mid-1990s, he's been a force of good. He's been working with tour operators, campaigning organizations, and in destinations right across the ecosystem with industry, government, and local communities. He's working to make sure that everything we do absolutely does work for a more responsible, sustainable future. Right here at WTM, he chairs the judges and oversees the World Responsible Tourism Awards and the family of awards associated with them in Africa, India, and Latin America. Harold's willingness to work across the travel and tourism ecosystem, connecting the dots to really unlock the full potential of sustainable impact, is to be saluted. And we do that right here and right now. Harold, please join us on the stage.
I was shocked when I got the email. I'd like to thank Vicky Smith. I never expected this, and certainly not from WTTC, about whom I've not always been very polite. But thank you. To be honest, following Radisson increases the value of the award to me. What Radisson have done is extraordinary. Anybody's done. And Red Carnation 2, Travel Corporation, Shannon McGuinn. Now, I thought that Shannon had been part of me getting this award, and I thought she'd be here tonight. And when I told her, she said she had nothing to do with it, which made the award even more extraordinary.